So, g'day, guys. Today we're speaking with Terry of Australian Metal Hardcore Punk Veterans Order of Chaos. Cheers for speaking with me, mate.
No problems at all, Cameron. Glad to be here.
Now, bar a few year hiatus some years back, Order of Chaos have been on the scene for over 20 years now, which is a massive achievement for any band. What inspires you to keep going?
Music. That's the one thing. The guys that I've playing with currently in the band, Matt Rizzo, Evan Coops, we've been together since 97, and previously the band had started in 95, so I'm the sole remaining original member, but these two guys have been there for the longest part of time anyway, and still to this day we like to create music and play that together and then perform it together when we do our shows.
Now, over the years, you've obviously witnessed heaps of bands and crowds and venues come and go. How would you say the metal and hardcore scenes are these days compared to when you started?
Well, one word comes to mind. It was a lot more underground when we started, and it was a smaller community. So as you sort of start your band, you know, befriend the people that are, you know, at the gigs and people who you start to play with. And, you know, it was a smaller community. Nowadays it's a lot bigger, and there's a lot more sort of scope for promotion with the internet and whatnot. It was just a lot different to try and get your band out there, you know, pre-internet sort of thing. So that's the first initial thing that comes to mind.
So getting back to you guys, obviously you recently stepped away from bass duties and brought Sean in as a full-time member. How's he going?
He's doing very, very well. We're going to have our first show with him in Sydney in 2 weeks' time at a festival called Under the Southern Cross, and that's the eighth year that they'll be running this. So he hasn't played any live gigs yet, but we've just been rehearsing, and he's just been learning stuff at a rapid rate to get our set together, and he's not fazed by anything we throw at him. So just as a side note, he's my brother, and we played in a few bands together through the years and stuff, and his style is a lot different than mine for playing bass, and it shows through in how he's adapting to the songs that we're giving him and some of the newer stuff that we're showing him as well. So he's just phenomenal to have, and allows me to concentrate solely on doing vocals and adding more dimensions than what I could do when I had to perform both bass and vocals. So it's really just a blessing and a gift at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, it was back in December 2014 when you first said that you were on the hunt for a new bass player. How many different guys did you try out between now and then, or was Sean always sort of the guy you were going to go to?
Well, Sean was always in the picture, being a family member and a close friend with everyone in the band already. We didn't overlook him, but we just thought, we'll just try and see if we can get anyone sort of from the community sort of thing. He's a metalhead, but he also likes to listen and write and perform lots of other stuff, so we weren't sure if he'd be sort of into it when we started looking. And there was a lot of people who said they wanted to step up to the plate, and then when it came time to come to the rehearsal room and meet and greet and do some jamming, everyone cancelled, and there was about four different people, and it just became this weird sort of Spinal Tap joke. It's like, all right, when's the next guy going to cancel? How many days before the rehearsal sort of thing? And that was a bit disheartening. So we got to a certain point where Evan, the guitarist, was just like, let's get your brother in and try. I'm like, well, you know, it can't hurt. And obviously it was the right thing to do, because everything's just gone really quickly from when he stepped in.
I'm
now that you can focus on your vocals, it's obviously the first time since like 2002 where you're going to be on stage without a bass in front of you. Are you
Yes.
going to feel a bit weird doing that? Like, are you used to having something to hide behind?
I can remember doing it. I've played in a few other bands over the years, and one of the other bands I used to play in was a group called Earth. So I did a good 3 or 4 years of being a frontman for Earth and also for Order of Chaos in about the same sort of a period of time, about 3 or 4 years, I sort of did it. So I've been off and on guitars and basses for this band, for Order of Chaos. So the guys were sort of like, does it feel weird? I'm like, no, it's just the job that's in front of me, so let's do it. But I guess time will tell whether I get weirded out by jumping up on stage. But I think I'll just sort of take to it and try my best. So fingers crossed.
Now, as you mentioned, the show is coming up is Under the Southern Cross Metal Fest in Sydney. Now, this is your first time playing there in a few years, I believe.
Yeah, actually, it's probably the first time in around 10 years, actually. You know, we had a 5-year hiatus in the early 2000s, and I think we went to Sydney just before we sort of ended it the first time around. So yeah, it has been a very long time in between drinks, and I've played in a few other bands. Going to Sydney and seeing it being, a different sort of atmosphere and culture nowadays. You know, younger people have come up, the old people are still there going out to gigs, which is really good to see. So we're just looking forward to getting up there and just showing people what we can do.
Absolutely. Do you have any gauge on like what your following is like up there these days?
Just through the powers of social media at the moment, there seems to be some of the older guys who obviously had heard us before, and also sort of obviously Matt Rizzo being from Blood Duster and a number of other bands, that sort of, you know, the ears prick up and go, oh, okay, Rizzo's playing and it's an older band, so they'll go back and sort of recheck us out, I guess. And there's been some people sort of going, oh, this is really cool, we're looking forward to seeing that. So, you know, the social media thing is like a cool thing. You can sort of see an instant response. So it's quite positive just to know there's at least someone sort of looking forward to checking us out.
Absolutely. So do you have any plans for any other interstate shows this year?
Not as yet, but we'd like to. So it's just a matter of getting the first one out of the way, and then just hopefully just, you know, just doing a bit of sort of networking and seeing what we can come up with. So we went to Canberra late last year, so that was a good sort of test of the waters because we hadn't been interstate for a number of years. So it's something that's definitely on the cards.
Awesome. And how about new material? Yeah, I think you might have briefly touched on it there. You might have a bit in the works.
Yeah, well, we started, I guess we've been writing ever since we released the last one, which was Deadweight Undertow in 2009. And basically from then until now, we've amassed about 15, 16 songs that are sitting there. I think the band can sort of play about half of them, and the other half are still in sort of a demo format. Between Evan, the guitarist, and myself, we sort of do about 70-30 or sort of 80-20 of the writing bulk and stuff. So I'm still sort of behind the scenes pushing out riffs and songs and stuff. So it's still good to be able to be a creative musician, even not being on a guitar or bass, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely. So are you going to be playing any of the new songs at the Southern Cross Metal Fest?
Nah, it'll all be stuff from the CDs that we've done, the two EPs and the two albums that we've done so far. So it's just sort of a reintroduction for people. So we're playing stuff anywhere from 97 through to 2014.
Awesome. So well, when can we expect to hear the new album then?
Well, as we've got a new member coming in and he's sort of learning the set, then the task is to sort of get him up to speed with what we've been doing with new material, and I guess it'll take a little while. So realistically, I think we'll probably have something new to share with everybody probably at the start of next year.
Awesome. Well, can't wait to hear it.
Cool.
All right, well, thank you very much for your time, Terry, and cheers for being Painkiller Bookings and Promotions Band of the Month.
Thank you very much, Cameron. And yeah, hats off to you guys for doing lots of promotion for all the local bands and putting on some great gigs also. So we're honoured to be Band of the Month. Thank you.